The M1 Abrams family of main battle tanks has been the backbone of U.S. armored forces for decades. The current frontline variant, the M1A2 System Enhancement Package, V3, SEP-V3, delivers heavy armor and powerful firepower to soldiers in combat. The new M1E3 represents the Abrams' next-generation upgrade, being developed to face emerging threats on the battlefields. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what's new in upcoming Abrams M1E3 MBT. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The M1A2 SEP-V3 uses the proven 120mm M256 smoothbore cannon as its main gun. This fires a variety of ammunition: long-rod APF-SDS rounds, heat shells, and newer programmable airburst munitions. A modern fire control suite, stabilized sights with a laser rangefinder, lets it accurately engage targets on the move. In addition, the SEP-V3 carries a coaxial 7.62mm machine gun and a roof-mounted remote weapon station, typically with a .50 caliber machine gun, for secondary fire. The upcoming M1E3 is expected to keep a 120mm main cannon, but with major enhancements. It will likely use a lighter, more advanced gun, such as the experimental XM360, paired with an autoloader that replaces the human loader. This allows a more compact turret and increases ammunition capacity. The M1E3 could also integrate new secondary weapons for air defense. Concepts include rapid-fire small-caliber cannons, anti-air missiles, or even directed energy laser systems to counter drones and incoming threats. The M1A2 SEP-V3 is equipped with state-of-the-art electro-optical and thermal sights. Its gunner and commander each have stabilized thermal imaging (FLIR) systems that combine long-wave and mid-wave infrared sensors, providing excellent night vision and target acquisition in obscure conditions. A high-resolution day camera and a laser rangefinder are also integrated for precise daytime targeting. These systems, along with a modern ballistic computer, let the SEP-V3 accurately engage threats at long distances. The M1E3 plans to expand these capabilities with a much wider sensor array and smarter processing. In addition to upgraded thermal and optical cameras, the M1E3 may include active scanning sensors, such as radar or LIDAR, to detect incoming threats or drone swarms at distance. High-resolution panoramic cameras around the vehicle will feed real-time video to the crew, and powerful onboard processors will run algorithms to highlight potential targets automatically. Crucially, the M1E3 will share sensor data with other units and unmanned systems via digital networks, achieving unprecedented situational awareness on the battlefield. The M1A2 SEP-V3's mobility comes from a Honeywell AGT-1500 gas turbine engine that produces about 1,500 horsepower. This power plant gives the roughly 67-ton tank strong acceleration and a top speed over 40 miles per hour, approximately 65 kilometers per hour on roads. The turbine is multi-fuel and works in extreme conditions, but it burns fuel heavily and generates a very loud exhaust. Overall, the SEP-V3's heavy weight limits its range around 265 miles, approximately 425 kilometers on road, and makes strategic transport more challenging. In contrast, the M1E3 is being developed with a hybrid electric drive. Adding batteries and electric motors alongside the main engine means longer range with less fuel. It will also be much quieter. Crews could move on battery power for silent maneuvering or run all systems off the batteries with the engine turned off. With a lighter chassis, targeting about 60 tons, roughly 20% less than today's Abrams, the M1E3 will accelerate faster and be easier to transport by air or over bridges. A hybrid drivetrain adds complexity, but it greatly improves tactical mobility and reduces the tank's thermal and acoustic signatures. The M1A2 SEP V3 has very thick composite armor with layers of steel, ceramics, and depleted uranium. Its turret and hull are reinforced to defeat enemy kinetic rounds and shaped charges. Additional protections include a self-sealing fuel system, internal spall liners, and an overpressure NBC nuclear biological chemical filtration system. Smoke grenade launchers and built-in sensors are used for threat warning. Some Abrams units carry the Israeli Trophy active protection system on the turret as an added layer of defense against incoming missiles. The M1E3 emphasizes even greater survivability while cutting weight. Its armor will use next-generation lightweight composites and modular panels that provide equivalent protection at reduced mass. Active protection is being built in from the start. M1E3 designs plan to integrate hard-kill countermeasures, automated launchers that shoot down incoming threats, and soft-kill systems into the hull and turret. By adopting an autoloader and possibly an unmanned turret, the M1E3 could reduce crew exposure, carrying only 3 crew members in a sealed hull, and pack more armor around them. The M1A2 SEP V3 features a modern digital backbone. It has data links and radios to share battlefield information with other units and onboard computers that run the fire control and vehicle health systems. Standardized line-replaceable modules are used for many electronics, simplifying maintenance. These systems give the SEP V3 much better connectivity and situational awareness than earlier Abrams models. By contrast, the M1E3 is being designed with a fully open, modular electronic architecture. It will comply with the latest Modular Open Systems Architecture, MOSA, standards, allowing new sensors, radios, and computers to be plugged in quickly. High-speed data buses and powerful processors will let the M1E3 run advanced software. For example, artificial intelligence could assist in target recognition and predictive maintenance. The tank's networks will integrate closely with other platforms, including drones, so that video and sensor data can flow to and from the vehicle instantly. Improved encryption and hardened communications will also be incorporated to secure all this connectivity in contested environments. Maintaining the M1A2 SEP V3 is a demanding task. The M1E3 aims to reduce this burden. Vehicle designers are packaging key components, engine, batteries, electronics, into replaceable modules, so field crews can swap them quickly. Greater parts commonality and use of commercial hardware, where possible, will shorten supply chains. Digital tools and predictive maintenance will also help. Data from each tank will guide preemptive repairs, further increasing reliability. The M1E3 should offer longer operational uptime and a lighter logistical footprint than the current Abrams.